So guys, in today's session, what we are going to do, so first of all, you should have MID with you and Protiset with you. So guys, do software with you. Let me ask the question. I'm going to share you the links. Name of the software, I would like to type it in the chat room. MID51, which we are going to use. MID51. This software, you can easily download it from the Google Chrome. Okay, I would like to show you that, or I would like to share its RAR file. Okay, so simply you can download MID51 from, you can simply download this MID51. Till then, for till rest of the student get joined to the session, please guys, you can go ahead, go into the Google Chrome. Simple. Okay, I would like to guide you through that. So I would like to share my screen, laptop screen. So guys, the screen is being shared right now at this moment, and I'm going to share, I would like to tell you MID51. So just go into the Google search engine. You can type MIDE51. Okay, you can download this from the above website, any of the website available over here. Then you will find out the tutorial as well, but no need to go for that tutorial, or you will find out the free version, free download Windows version from this website as well. Okay, so what you need to do, you have to just download the MIDE51.exe file. So just click on this file and let me know in the chat section guys whether you are getting or not the things which I am telling. That it's simple, very straightforward. MIDE51 you have to download. Choose the most popular programs from audio. No, not needed. We are interested in downloading this. Okay, so do we have the link for that? Let's check. No, this is not the proper link. Okay, comments, MID informers, one user write about the, you can check package builder and other like add download the download section. So let us check the download section. Okay, I don't think there is a download section available over here. Okay, Software Informer, download popular programs. Yeah, shall we check for the downloads? Because I'm already having that. Yeah, all downloads. All software downloads. Okay, the name of software is MID51, so let's focus on this MID51. So do we have that MID51 with us? If not, we can go ahead. If yes, then no need to go around. Okay, so it has a lot of software right now guys. No need to go onto this website. Simply I would like to go back and I would like to search for this MID. Yeah, can we have the free development? Okay, again the same website. Okay, okay, so no issues guys. What I would like to do, 364 KB. okay, okay, so if it's downloadable, I have to tell you that yeah, this is the downloadable link. And you can download MID. Yeah, okay guys, I'm done with MID51. So guys, in today's part, would you like to install software client? No, I don't want. Guys, I would like to share you the link for the MID51. So on the session, I would like to tell you this. So this is the link to download the MID51. Is it real? It is only .exe now? Yes, Harshal. Actually, this is a zip file, MID51. Okay, so this is a zip file, and I have okay, so this is a zip file. You can download this from this link, guys. Almost 19 users are there right now, right in real time. We were expecting 40 plus users, because already 50 plus users have already registered to the course. Hello Akshita, hello Archana ma'am, Supriya, Shraddha, hello everyone, Yash, Niyati, hello everyone. So shall we start? Shall we start with the session? It's almost 16:10. So shall I go with the 8051 microcontroller? Yeah. So guys, what you need to do, we will provide the recording of this session as well. So whatever steps which I am following right now, you have to follow the same steps. I think you don't have the Protease 8 with you. How many of you have Protease 8 simulation software installed in your laptop? Please let me know. How many of you have Protease 8 installed? Pragati, okay. Yash ke paas bhi hai. Supriya, yes. What about others? Reena, nahi, okay. What about others? Please reply, guys. Ame, no. Niyati, no. Yeah, okay. Yes, no. Theek hai. Falguni, yes. So, right now 20 users are there. So, almost out of 20, 10 users don't have Protease 8 installed in their laptop or in their desktop. Okay, no issues. So, I would like to tell you the link to download the Protease 8. तो आज सेशन खत्म होने के बाद आपको क्या करना है कि प्रोटीस 8 आपको डाउनलोड करना है एंड एमआईडी 51. गाइस देखो, हमारा जो कोर्स है वो सिर्फ 5 दिन का है. यस्टरडे सेशन वाज फ्री सेशन. सो 4 सेशन में 4 सेशन में 4 कंट्रोलर सिखाऊंगा मैं. 8051, देन पिक, देन आर्डिनो, एंड देन फोर्थ वाला एलपीसी 2148, दैट इज आर्म 7. तो ये 4 मैं पढ़ाने वाला हूं. तो हर एक सेशन में एक कंट्रोलर खत्म होने वाला है. खत्म मतलब जीपीआईओ प्रोग्रामिंग उसका कैसे करना है, क्या करना है, बिकॉज प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम में आपको वो एग्जीक्यूट कैसे करना है, दैट इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट गाइस. ठीक है. सो प्रोटीस 8 अगर आपको इंस्टॉल करना है, तो अगेन आई डू हैव दैट लिंक विथ मी. लेट मी टेल यू द लिंक एज वेल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी हैव दैट फाइल विथ मी. So I will again start the screen sharing. Sir, please use less Hindi. Okay, Shri Vallabh, no issues. Thank you for your suggestion, Shri Vallabh. You might be from Kerala. Are you from the Bangalore? From south part? Yeah, South India. Yeah. Thank you, Shri Vallabh. And from where did you come to know about my session, Shri Vallabh? Did you come to know about from college? Okay, college group. Yeah, that's great. Thank you, Shri Vallabh. You're proud. Right. I'm feeling really proud that my knowledge is being circulated in your South Indian colleges as well. Okay, thank you, Shri Vallabh. Now henceforth, I'm not going to use any Hindi word. Yeah, will that be fine? Yeah. So thank you for guiding us and asking us to go with that. Yeah, so let's start with guys now. So first of all, I would like to share the laptop screen. So laptop screen I have shared. Now I would like to tell you the software. First of all, those who were left, for them, let me know, guys. We have downloaded the MID 51 software, which we required for the programming of 8051 microcontroller, and the link for the same as well. I would like to share. ठीक है? Okay, sorry. There is bit Hindi pronunciation in my language. Yeah, sorry for that. No issues. Now, in order to download the MID 51, so I will also share this text file, guys, with you people to download MID 51 software. So download MID 51 software. You can use this link, guys. I will share this text file through the mail IDs. Okay, so you have already registered onto the Wikinode portal. So I would like to share this text file, entire text file, to download MID software, then to download Arduino library, then to download the Proteus 8 Professional with Crack. Okay, guys, see, you can use this Proteus 8 Professional software, but never tell anyone that I have shared this link with you people, because you will find out this onto the YouTube or onto the Google Chrome, and you can simply download that with the help of a crack version. Okay, if you are not installing crack version, then it is really impossible to run the simulations. So this link as well I will share with you people. So in today's session, we would like to go with MID 51, how to program 8051. So let me start with 8051 microcontroller, guys. So let me stop and let's focus on the whiteboard. So I would like 8051 microcontroller and a bit introduction to the 8051 microcontroller. So let's start with whiteboard screen. And welcome to Wikinode, guys. Let's start. So if you are a mobile user, keep in mind that you have made a certain changes, such as hide the user's list, then make sure that you have made a full screen and I am completely audible as well as the screen is visible. So let's start, guys, here. So we'll start with 8051 microcontroller and its pin structure. So in 8051 microcontroller, it's an 8-bit microcontroller. This is the basic microcontroller of all. It's an 8-bit microcontroller. Let's have its features. 8-bit microcontroller. Then how much amount of RAM does it have? So it has 256 bytes of on-chip RAM. Okay, on-chip RAM in order to program this. Whenever I deal with this, because I'm very much interested into the RAM then ROM. So it has 4 KB of on-chip ROM. Okay, ROM stands for read-only memory. RAM stands for RAM memory. And very external, it is a 40-pin IC. So 40-pin IC, four ports. Ports means, look at the structure of 80 controller. See here, guys, if this is a 805 controller, then this is a 40-pin IC and it comes in dual-in package, DIP package. So we do have 40 pin on the left-hand side. Similarly, 21, go on counting till 40th pin. Okay, so the first pin, and this is 20th pin, this is 21st pin, and this is 40th pin. So with respect to this, I would like to tell you what is this pin number 20 and what is this pin number 40. So 40 number pin is used as a VCC connection, guys, plus VCC, and 20 number pin is connected to the ground. It is used as a ground connection, and we have to use two more pins which are used as a crystal oscillator input. Okay, so I would like to show this crystal oscillator input over here. So these two pins are used as a crystal oscillator input, and here you will find out the two inputs. One is for the oscillator 1 and one is for the oscillator 2. So as it has a 4 ports, what are the names of the 4 ports? In yesterday's session as well, I have told you about this, but let me again tell you about that. It has a 4 ports, and which are those 4 ports? See, guys, I would like to tell you this in over here, that we do have 40 pins with us. 40 pins are divided into 4 ports. First port is a port 0. Name of first port is port 0. Second one is port 1. Third one is port 2, and fourth one is port 3. Okay, so port 0 has 8 pins, port 1 has 8 pins, similarly port 2 also has 8 pins, and port 3 has 8 pins. So again, I would like to go with the back to the features. So here I will find, out of 40 pin IC, if this is a 40 pin IC, out of 40 pin, 32 pins are used as a digital input output general purpose pins. So 32 pins are used as a general purpose input output, and these pins are used in order to interface various peripherals to this 8051 microcontroller. Guys, did you clear this basic of 8051? This point, because I haven't asked you any question based on this. Omkar, Gauri, Falguni, let me know. Did you come to know about the 8051? This much basic is more than enough, because we are not here to study theoretical points, guys, or it's working. We are here to program 8051 microcontroller or rest of the microcontrollers. Okay, Harshal? Yes. Shri Vallabh, now is that fine? Shri Vallabh Sharma, is that fine? Now, are you understanding in what way I am teaching? Yeah, okay. Thank you, Shri Vallabh. So, Shri Vallabh, do you have this course, embedded system course, in your college? Do you belong to engineering domain, or are you from already done? Okay, great. Electronic communication engineering. Okay. I think Gauri, you are an industry expert, industry professional from Mumbai. Am I correct, Gauri? You are not a student. If I'm not wrong. Yeah. Okay. So guys, let's focus. Okay. Great to have Gauri on this Wikinode platform. You have already subscribed to our channel, Wikinode channel. And I think yesterday also you were present for the session, live session. So guys, let's focus here. 8 pins over here. Port 1 has 8 pins. Then port 2 has 8 pins and port 3. And they are designated in this fashion. P0.0 to P0.7. Similarly, port 1 is designated in this fashion. P1.0 to P1.7. Port 2 is designed in this fashion. P2.0 to P2.7. So these are designated, means every pin has this kind of nomenclature. Port 3 is designated from P3.0 to P3.7. So here we are not going to have the port structure and all, but guys, in order to program the ports, see, keep in mind some features of port. I would like to tell you some features of port in this part. Features of ports. So what are the role of this port and its pins? See, its pins. So what is its role that we have to study? So keep in mind, ports, if this is my structure of 8051 microcontroller, then it has 8 pins. A group of 8 pins is called as a port. Here also we will find out the group of 8 pins. Here also we will find out the group of 8 pins. So this is not I have made appropriately, but just I have to give some glimpses of the programming. So suppose this is 8051 microcontroller. All the pins, here you will find out a notch and a dot over here. So it indicates about the IC and how to check down the pin counting 1 to 20 and then 21 to 40, like this, in this fashion. So guys, keep in mind, if individual pin can be accessed, at a time. Individual pin means, see, suppose I want to send some data. This is P0 port, this is P1, then this is P2 and this is P3. Okay, we are not interested in that right now. So keep in mind, because Proteus 8 simulation will provide us the pin diagram and all. Keep in mind, guys, if I'm using an instruction set B P2.0. Yesterday also I have told you set B P2.0. Its meaning is set the bit at P2.0 pin. So that means this pin will act as a high. Suppose consider this pin is P2.0. So this pin will act as a high. Even if I want to send a low value to this pin, then I have to use the instruction clear P2.0. This is that much simple. This works in this fashion. Okay. Similarly, if suppose I want to send the entire value. So now, how many pins do each port have? My question is, please reply in the chat section. How many pins do each port has? 8 pins. Very good, Pragati, Yash, Gauri. Yeah, thank you. Yes, very good, Kunal. So every port has 8 pins with it. Out of this 8 pins, guys, suppose I am individually accessing a single pin. Am I correct? Now suppose I want to access the entire port, all 8 pins of this port, then my instruction would be like this. Move. I have to take down some value into the accumulator. Accumulator is a 8-bit register. Keep in mind, guys, At the very start, I told you that 8051 microcontroller is an 8-bit microcontroller. So 8-bit means I can simply process 8 bits of data at a time. So move a comma, suppose I am writing some value and that value is suppose like this, in this fashion, hash. Hash indicates me that I am loading some immediate value into the accumulator register. And accumulator register is an 8-bit register. So what value suppose I want to transfer? So I have written like this. Please check here, 4 times 1, then 4 times 1. So this is an 8-bit value and at the end I have written B. B stands for binary over here, guys. So I am loading this binary immediate value into the accumulator. So what will be the contents of accumulator after this? So it will have this value. And after that, suppose I am writing like this, move P0 comma A. So keep in mind, here left hand side is always acts as a destination, while right hand side will always act as a source. So first, in the first instruction, I have loaded an 8-bit value into the accumulator, and then from accumulator, I have loaded it into the P0 port. So I have told you the method of first individual accessing of particular pin by setting or clearing that pin, and second method by sending an 8-bit of value directly. Okay, so guys, from henceforth, what will be my next step? Keep in mind, always keep in mind, simple, this you have to keep in mind for the rest of the sessions, guys, and even it will be helpful for your programming as well. So you what you have to do, when what is the significance of B after set instruction? Good question, Kunal. Keep in mind that P2.0 is an individual pin, single pin. So B stands for bit. Here this B stands for set bit. B stands for bit. Okay, so accumulator is like RAM. Yash is asking. Yash, actually accumulator is a part of RAM. Accumulator register is a part of RAM. Suppose we are right now having this RAM. So RAM has general purpose register, special purpose register, accumulator, suppose A register, B register, then general purpose registers like R0 to R7 like this. Okay, then we do have the special function registers, SFRs with us, and some scratchpad RAM is also available. Scratchpad RAM we will call it as. So accumulator is a part of RAM. I would not say accumulator is like RAM. Are you getting the difference, Yash? Accumulator is a part of RAM. Okay, and these are the registers which are used to store the data for temporary purpose, to store the result of the operations. That's it. That's the use of these registers. So you have to just deal with the guys, this kind of general purpose registers. So GPRs, yeah, we have seen some GPRs over here, that accumulator, then B register, R0 to R7 like this. We are going to use those registers, but we are not going to go in that much depth. So let's focus here, guys. I was explaining you some concepts. So move next, suppose my instruction is like this, move A comma, suppose I have written hash 4 times 0, then again 4 times 0. Now this is also an 8-bit form value for me, and this hash or the pound character indicates me that this is an immediate value. And how many bit value? This is an 8-bit value which is I am loading into the accumulator register. And after that you will find out the move, and suppose I am writing like this, move P1 comma A, that means I am transferring or loading the accumulator value into the P1. So guys, from henceforth, what I was expecting you people to remember, that you have to make one table. If you do have a notebook with you people right now, then keep in mind you have to make table, and that table will be definitely useful for you people for the entire guys, I'm getting one call. Maybe that's from a subscriber who is not able to log in. Just give me a moment. Till then, I would like to ask you. I will guide that subscriber about how to join the session. Till then, what you do, you just make a table. So your table will be in this fashion. Please take a pen and pencil. I'm expecting you all should write down this table, because this table will definitely help you guys. And this table has three columns. First is decimal number. This is decimal number column. Okay, freehand. Decimal number. Then you have to go with binary number. Guys, everyone out over there, please, you have to go with this. And then hexadecimal number, hex number. Till what bit? Yeah, yes, main batata hu. Yes, I would like to tell you that. So first starts with decimal number 0, then 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then you go with the 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Till go till 15. After 15, just wait. Binary number 0 will be represented as, how to represent this 0? No. We have to use 4 bits. Yes, because we are displaying till 15 now. Can we display 15 value with the help of 3 bit? No, not possible. So 0, 0, I would like to go with 4 times 0. Correct now? And don't forget to write down B. Yes. 1, 1, you have to write down this with the help of 0001. 2, you have to, I'm going with so much basic guys. 3, you have to go with 0011. 4, you have to go with 0100. 5, you have to go with 0101. 6, go like this, 0011. 7, 0111. 8, 1000. 9, 1001. 10, 1010. 11, 1011. Then 12, everyone out there, you have to make counting with me. 12, then 13, 1101, then 14, 1110, and 15, last 15, yeah. Okay, I would like to scratch this, 15, so 15 will be written as 4 times 1, yeah. Correct, Kunal. Thank you. So this is why I'm telling you guys. Now see, hexadecimal number, it is having a base of 16, while binary number has a base of 2. Radix, we used to call it as a radix, and decimal number has a base of 10. So each hexadecimal number digit is represented by one single digit, 0H. 0001H. It is written as 1H, then 2H. So we have to go on this counting till 9, guys. So at 9, we will have 9H. But 10, we can't represent 10 by 10H. We have to use, yes, anybody? You have that concept ready with you? 10, how to use 10? Yes. So for 10, we have to use, very good, Srivallav, Herschel, very good, AH. For 11, it would be BH. For 12, CH. Then for 13, DH. Then for 14, EH. And yes, very good, yes. And last, FH. So this H signifies me it's an hexadecimal number. Am I correct, guys? It's a hexadecimal number. Now, with respect to the port programming, guys, you should know about this table. That is my expectation. So are you guys done with the table? So that, let me go ahead. Okay, very good, Krishna. Very good, Harshal. Okay, so you are done, guys. I was expecting you should take some Ramesh. Yes, I will wait for you, Ramesh. And even as I said, Gauri, I have to pick one call. Maybe subscriber is trying to join the session and he's not able. able to join the session. So let me focus on that. Till then, those who haven't completed the table, please go through the table. Just give me bits of break so that I will call the subscriber. Okay guys, hope you are done with this. Okay, so if you are done with this, guys, let me tell you this one more thing. At the very start, I have told you about this, that I have to use this instruction. Am I correct? I have to use this instruction. Yes, Kunal is asking, I wasn't there for 15 minutes. Kunal, keep in mind, we are also providing the recording of this session. You can watch it later. Okay. And next time, everyone over there, please be on time so that you won't miss anything in the real time. Now, let's focus here. Guys, see, what rule we have studied, that four binary digits are represented by single hexadecimal digit, 0001, by single hexadecimal digit. Similarly, 4 times 1 represented by single hexadecimal digit. Whenever you have to deal with microprocessor and micro, you have to deal with, guys, the hexadecimal programming, hexadecimal values. So here, can you guys tell me what will be the significance or what will be the instruction if I would like to write down the same instruction in hexadecimal? So move a comma, anybody would like to try, move a comma hash. So these are the four ones, then followed by again four ones and followed by b. So what necessary changes I have to make? This 4-1 will be replaced by FF. Very good, Pragati. Very good, Amri. Very good. So you have to write down FF, correct now? And followed by, you have to write down H. But Pragati, Ame, you are totally correct. Kunal, you are totally correct. But you have made one mistake, guys. Can you tell me that mistake? Do you know about that mistake? Any one of you? If not, yes, I am going to correct you guys about that. Keep in mind, yes, very good, Shrivallabh, yes, we have to write down it as a 0FF. So why it is 0FF? That this 0 will indicate you people that this F is not an alphabet, while it's an hexadecimal number. Did you get the point, guys? What does this 0 indicate? It won't generate any opcode. So this 0 indicates that the letter followed by this 0 is not an alphabet, but it's a hexadecimal number. That's it. That's why we have to use 0H. Suppose if I am writing like this, move a comma hash 1FH, then it is correct, guys? Is it correct 1FH? Is it correct? Did you understand the concept, Pranav? Why it's not correct, beta? Yes, Gauri, it's totally correct. Pranav, this is correct. Because see here, Pranav, I have used 1FH. If it would have been like this, move a comma hash F1H. If it would have been like this, then at the F, before F, preceding to the F, I have to write 0. Understood, everyone over there? Did you understand the rule that if after the pound character, if there is an immediate hexadecimal alphabet number, then you have to prefix that hexadecimal number, hexadecimal alphabet with 0. Everyone, have you understand the rule? Have you understood the rule? Okay, Amay, very good. So chalo, I would like to take your test now. See here, let me know. Just I'm asking you whether the concepts are clear or not. Which instructions are correct? Let me know. Let me know the instructions. Move A comma hash 20B, then third instruction, move A comma hash, then 0FB, then 2H, then fourth, move A comma hash 1DH. Okay. So out of these four instructions, which instructions are correct instructions? My question. Please listen to the question. 1, 3, 4. 1, 3, 4. How many of you are with 1, 3, 4? Ameya, Pragati, Kunal are saying that 1, 3, 4 are correct. Gauri is saying only first and fourth is correct. All are wrong, I think so. Yes. Yes. So I think you didn't understood the concept. It's wrong. Gauri, again you are confusing, getting confused. Your first answer was correct, Gauri. See here guys. Sri Vallabh, no, wrong. Only first instruction and fourth instructions are correct. Very good, Shibiluddin. Where are you from, Shibiluddin? Where are you from? Are you from Pune or out of Pune? Yeah. Guys, why first and fourth is correct? Let me tell you guys this. Because is the very basic reason, Pune. Okay, great. So the first reason is 20H is the hexadecimal value. What is size of this accumulator? Accumulator can accommodate only 8 bits of size. 20H can be written as, how to split this 20H? This 2 will be written as 0010. And this next 0 will be written as, will be represented by 4 binary bits. So is it an 8 bit binary number? Yes. Correct now? Yes. So this is an 8 bit binary number, and which we are loading into the accumulator, beta. Yeah. Okay. So this is correct instruction. First instruction. Look at the second instruction. 20B. Let me tell you, in binary numbers, we only have 0 and 1. Do we have 2 with us in binary numbers? All of you, my question. Do we have the numbers like 2, 3? No. So this is also wrong instruction. Understood? So see here, I have written B now. B stands for binary, 0, 1. So this is wrong. Then, now see here, accumulator can accommodate only 8 bits of data. Yes. You will get everything practically, yes, here in this session. I am not here to discuss the theoretical things. Okay. But I am telling you some programming skills. Okay. Move A comma hash 0FB2H. Now look at this value. Yes, you are totally correct that F, there should be, before an hexadecimal alphabet, there should be prefix 0. But here keep in mind guys, this is how many bit number? How many bit number? FB2H. Kitne bit ka number ho gaya? 8 bit, 12 bit, 32 bit, 12 bit. Gauri Pimparkar, sorry beta, this is 8 bit number, 12 bit number, 12. Ye 0 discard karne ka yahan pe. F ke pehle use kiya, discard karo isko. Okay? So this is going to be a 12 bit number. So you understood the rule guys. यू अंडरस्टूड द रूल, मैंने जो टेबल ड्रॉ किया था वो क्यों किया था आपको समझ में आया ना फिर, कि टेबल जो ड्रॉ किया था हमने कहाँ गया हमारा टेबल, डू वी हैव टेबल दैट फोर बाइनरी बिट प्रिंटेड बाय सिंगल हेक्साडेसिमल डिजिट, ओके, सो कीप इन माइंड हियर दिस इज 12 बिट एंड वी कैन अकोमोडेट ओनली 8 बिट्स ऑफ डेटा, इंस्ट्रक्शन इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग, सेकेंड इंस्ट्रक्शन इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग, एंड वॉट अबाउट फोर्थ, वॉट इज रॉन्ग इन फोर्थ, देर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन द फोर्थ, आई हैव रिटर्न हैश 1DH, सो दिस इज कम्प्लीटली करेक्ट एंड वी आर लोडिंग 8 bits of data into the accumulator. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Okay. So done with the programming part, guys. So did you like this? So shall we go for the interfacing with LED 8051 LED, and then we would like to go with, guys. See, the first two sessions will be a bit at slower pace, means you will understood everything. So today I would like to complete you people with the LED interfacing and then LCD interfacing. Reena, I think you are happy now. Pragati, Srivallab, happy with the course registration? Otherwise you might have felt, yaar, khama ka 100 rupees waste kiya humne. Knowledge mil raha hai na? Are you getting knowledge from this session, Gauri? Yeah, thank you. If though you know the concept Gargi, keep in mind Gargi, Reena, everyone out of there, Ramiz, you may know the concept, but you have to program these controllers by yourself, and that confidence can be boosted with the help of this session, guys. That I can guarantee. Okay, so that's the main thing, that we are not going to study things theoretically over here, but practically. So let's have the interfacing of L. So first of all theoretically padhenge, fir hum usko simulate karke dekhenge. So LED interfacing, to software kaun sa use karne wale hain, hum kaun se microcontroller ke bare mein pad rahe hain. Guys, keep in mind, I always keep focusing on the concepts. So we are studying about 8051 microcontroller, and we are going to interface a peripheral, that is LED now. Okay, so here LED interfacing, you should have the diagram with you people. So diagram, I would like to draw the diagram first. So in order to make the diagram, yes, the software is MID51. Very good, Kunal. MID51 is going to be our software in order to program 8051. You can use Keel, guys. I am going with my software right now, and link will be shared through the mails. Okay, I would like to share the that text document. MID51, the programming language. So let's have some basic fundas with us. What are our requirements, pre-requirements? Okay, so that whenever you will find out the nodes, then it will be easy for you people. So first of all, controller, microcontroller, MUSI. Here I would like to write MUSI, which microcontroller we are going to use. 8051 based microcontroller. I am going to use 8089C51RD2 microcontroller. Name of microcontroller is this. This is using 8051 microcontroller architecture. Okay, second, then which software used? Software used to program. Software is MID51. So we will make some list like this, MID51. Then for simulation, we have to use simulation. For simulation, I am going to use Protease 8 Professional. Okay, so this is going to be our software, Protease 8 Professional for simulation. Now what we have to do here, and the same agenda we will follow, guys, in order to program every microcontroller, pre-requirements will be like this. Guys, keep in mind, this is software simulation, software simulation. But if you want to run it on hardware platform, you have to use for the execution of this microcontroller, then you have to use one software. You might have heard about the name of this software, Flash Magic. Have you heard about this software, guys? Flash Magic. And very important, the programming language. Okay, the programming language. So language which we are going to use, keep in mind, whenever you are going to study about the controllers now, from henceforth, you have to make the notes in this fashion. So programming language is going to be my assembly language. Assembly language is low level language. Yes, for burning program into hardware. Very good, Yash. So assembly language over here. ठीक है? Yeah. So guys, in the same fashion, in the next time as well, please remind me about making pre-requirements before the interfacing. So this will be your key notes, guys. Programming language, then hardware platform will have Flash Magic, which we are not going to do. We are online right now, so I will show you the software simulations and all. Now LED interfacing, let's focus here. 8051 UC, it has one pin connected to VCC, one pin connected to ground, then one pin connected to crystal, two pins connected to crystal oscillator connection. So this is very important thing which one should remember, crystal oscillator. Why I used to focus on this, guys, keep in mind here notch and then followed by dot. Guys, keep in mind that every microcontroller must have the power supply and must have the crystal oscillator connection. Why it is so? Because this microcontroller will be dead if we are not providing the oscillator frequency to him as well as the power supply. Okay, so 8051 microcontroller, we are going to interface a single LED. So LED, we are connecting this LED in the common. It has two connection, one is anode, one is cathode. Guys, I am going in so much basic way, but for Arduino, for LPC2144, for PEEK, I am not going to repeat these things. So those who are right now attending the session, though it's basic for, is for timers. Yes, no, it's not the case. Yes, crystal oscillator connection is not just only for the timers. It is a clock it provides the clock frequency or the heartbeats. हमारे दिल में क्या होता है, sorry for the Hindi, in our heart we have to provide the pumping of the blood every time. So we do have 72 strokes within 1 minute. Am I correct? So it's like a crystal frequency. And if that frequency is dead, clock frequency is dead, then everything is going to be dead. So like that, here, that's crystal oscillator frequency. Timer utilizes, not only timer, each and every peripheral which is present inside the microcontroller uses the crystal oscillator frequency. But directly as it is, frequency is never used, it uses a part of the frequency. Okay. That part we'll study later, Yash. Let's focus here. LED has two connection, anode and cathode. Suppose I am interfacing it to the P0.0 port. P0.0. Or suppose I would like to tell this, take down P1.0. So P1.0 single LED. In order to, I want to blink this LED. I want to flash this LED or blink this LED. On off, on off, on off. So continuously I have to do on off. So logic is very important, guys, and for that, what logic you have to do. So first of all, let me start with this. Everyone over here, are you getting bored, guys? Yeah, are you feeling interesting? Excited for the programming now? Excited for the programming? Okay, yes, yes. Okay, Reena, good. Good, yes. So very good, Gauri. Yes, this is the basic program, but guys, if you know about LED programming, then you can go for the LCD programming as well. So let's focus on this LED programming. So we are going to use MID51 software, and the name of the file will be .asm. So let's start with the program. So I would like to start with ORG00H. Then here simply I would like to write set B. Now you are going to tell me this meaning of this instruction. Then call some delay. This is the assembly language, guys. Huh? Assembly language. A call delay. And I will explain each and every sentence of this program. Clear P1.0. Then again call delay. Assembly language means it don't have the case sensitive. It is not a case sensitive language. Then let's jump main. Okay. So before that, delay. Purposefully, I am not writing some labels. because I am expecting you should complete those levels, move r0 comma hash 255, then move r1 comma hash 100, okay, then dj nz r1 comma here dj nz r0 comma here 1, and here I would like to write here 1, okay, and then ret, return, don't never forget to write down the return, and then end. Now guys, just keep in mind, everyone listen here now carefully, this is just a delay routine. It is called as a delay routine, and role of delay routine is to generate a delay. And what is use of delay, that we would like to see. So first of all, set B P1.0, what will be the meaning of this? In the interfacing diagram, you have seen that LED is interfaced to the P1.0. If we are sending a high value to this LED, then this LED will become turned on. Am I correct? So set B P1.0, that means the LED will be turned on. E called delay. So that means my instruction pointer will go for the execution of the routine whose name is delay. Okay, so it will go for the execution. Where delay is written, it is written over here, and in front of delay you will find out two dots. So this is the label. Subroutine is the name of that subroutine, function's name. And here I am loading 255 value into the R0 register, 100 value into the R1 register, and then I am decrementing. See guys, what value we have loaded into the R1? 100 value. DJNZ stands for decrement R1 register, and its value is always decremented by 1. Decrement R1 by 1 and jump if not 0. Where we have to jump? Where we have to jump? After comma they have written here. So it will jump again here. Yeah, the loop will run for 255 into 100 times. Very good, Yash. But let me ask other as well, whether they are understanding the concept or not. Keep in mind guys here, let's focus here, that it's like a your for loop. It's like a for loop which you use to design in your C programming. So R1 has 100 value. Suppose R1 has 100 value. Through this instruction DJNZ, decrement R1 by 1. So R1's value will be decremented by 1 and it will have value 99. And check, jump if not 0, and check whether that value is 0. If not 0, jump if not 0, where we have to jump? Here. So again it will execute this instruction. So your instruction pointer will keep on executing the same instruction, because here label is written in front of the same instruction. It will keep on, it will be in the loop until and unless R1's value becoming 0. Are you understood? Did you understand the concepts guys? It will remain into the same loop until and unless R1's value becomes 0. Once it is become 0, it will come out of this loop and it will execute the next instruction. Here the instruction is DJNZ R0 comma here 1. Kunal, focus here. Kunal, what is value which you have loaded into the R0? Kunal, focus here at the start. R0 has 255 value. Okay. Now, instruction meaning is D stands for decrement. We have to decrement the value of R0 by how much? By how much? By just a 1 value. Yes. So R0's value will become 254. Okay? 254. And after D, we have written JNZ. Jump if not 0. 254. Whether it is equal to 0? My question is, it is asking here whether it is equal to 0. My answer is no. If no, then where we have to jump? We have to jump here 1. Okay? So here 1, if it is not 1, then it will go here. Again, R1 will have 100 value. Yes, like this. So at the start, yes, told us 255 times multiplied by 100. So this 100 multiplied by 255. For this many machine cycles, it will remain into the same loop. You don't worry about this loop, guys, right now at this moment, because this is not a practically good method to go with the resistor delay generation with the help of resistor. Okay, so can anybody tell me if in the interview, company interview, they ask you how much delay will be generated over here? So just tell them that to whatever value which is written over here, 255 100, this many machine cycles delay will be generated. Now again come into the mind, if suppose he or she interviewer ask you that 255 multiplied by 100, it's almost 25500 machine cycles. Am I correct? This many machine cycles. But in terms of time, in terms of seconds, in terms of minutes, how much delay is generated? So guys, keep in mind, your 8051 microcontroller suppose it works on 11.0592 megahertz frequency. It works on 11.0592 megahertz frequency. Keep in mind, guys. And this frequency is provided by whom? Your crystal oscillator. Your crystal oscillator provides this much amount of frequency. But this frequency, whenever it enters inside the microcontroller, it gets divided by the factor of 12 in order to generate a one machine cycle frequency. And what do you mean by one machine cycle? One machine cycle means it is the frequency required to execute a single instruction. See here, guys, this is a single instruction, ORGOH. Set B1.0, single instruction. A call delay, single instruction. Clear P1.0, single instruction. So for single instruction, so for this single instruction, for what? One machine cycle frequency. So this can be changed also. Simulation, yes, we can change in the simulation. But if it is fixed through hardware, we can't change. Yes. So one machine cycle frequency. Have you understood the concept of machine cycle frequency, guys? Machine cycle frequency. It is the frequency required to execute a single instruction. Instruction can be executed through a machine cycle. So guys, simply what you have to do now, calculate the frequency over here. Do you have calculus with you? Anybody? Can anybody tell me what is frequency? This 11.0592 mega divided by 12. I think this is 921.8 kilohertz according to my knowledge. 921.6. Okay. Okay, kilohertz. So let me correct this. 921.6 kilohertz. So this much frequency will be generated through here. And we know that this is frequency. So we can simply calculate the time. So time is equal to t is equal to 1 by f. And it comes around 1.08 microseconds, 0825 something is there. 1.08 microsecond, t is equal to 1 by f. Because this is going to a frequency. And just multiply this machine cycles with this much amount of time, you will get the delay. That's it. So guys, I think we can complete only LED interfacing today. So guys, did you understood the concept? Shall I go with the programming? This was the not, actually this was not the part of our curriculum right now, syllabus, because it's lot to study, and within 7.5 hours, I am expecting that you should be aware with the programming, guys. Okay? So let's focus here. So here I was supposed to tell you that here LED got turned on. Then I have called some delay. Then we went for the execution of delay. And keep in mind, RET stands for return, return from the subroutine. So return, after the execution of return, my instruction pointer will again come to the executable next instruction after through from which it was called. It was called from here na, a call delay, then it went for the execution, it has executed that, then it has executed return, and through return again it went for the next instruction after the a call delay instruction. Here the instruction is clear P1.0. So here the LED will become turned off and it will remain turned off for some time. So we have again called a call delay. But guys, suppose I want to do this program infinitely for infinite times, then what should be done? ये तो सिर्फ एक ही टाइम हो गया अभी एग्जीक्यूट या सॉरी फॉर द हिंदी इट गॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड ओनली वंस बिकॉज इट गॉट रन ओनली वंस ऑल फोर इंस्ट्रक्शंस गॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड इन सीक्वेंस बट आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग दिस प्रोग्राम शुड रन फॉर नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स इनफिनाइट टाइम्स व्हाट शुड बी डन व्हाट इज योर क्ल्यू गाइस व्हाट विल बी योर what you would like to tell me? Loop, yes, very good. Set R1 to 100. No, Vaibhav, no, Shivallav, R0 to 255. No, that's wrong. S jump, very good, Kunal. Yes, so I have to take down a short jump and that short jump will be in this fashion, guys. Short jump, keep in mind here, short jump main. Short jump, name of label is main. So I would like to write that main over here. What will happen now? See, in the sequence, he has executed all these four instructions. S jump main means, again, it will jump from this main, where main loop is written here. So again, it will go for. So continuously, LED on off, on off, on off, on off will take place. And role of this delay is, if suppose LED has been turned on, then it will remain turned on for certain time interval. Then LED has been become turned off and it will remain turned off for certain time interval. That's it. Done with the program. Anyone over there? Do you have any issues right now? Have you understood the code? Kunal, Yash, what about others? Amaya, okay, great, great. Pragati, very good, Reena. Yes, Shivallab, let me know which programming language is it? Which programming language I have used here? Let me know the programming language. From tomorrow onwards, guys, keep in mind. Yes, assembly, very good, assembly language. So from tomorrow onwards, guys, keep in mind that you have to keep a notebook with you people. You will write some important points. Yes, no doubt I am going to provide you the recordings of the session, but still real time you can ask me some doubts if you have any. Okay, so shall I go for the programming then? So I would like to go with the programming and I am starting my screen sharing. I am done with the explanation, theoretical explanation. Now I would like to go with the code. Okay, so let's go with the code now, guys. So I'm sharing the laptop screen. I would like to take down what you have to take down. Keep in mind you have one new notepad file, so just right click and take down a notepad file, text document, I would say text document, because it will be easy for you people for the visibility. Then I would like to increase the font as well. Okay, so I would like to type with the code ORG00H, then set B P1.0, then A call delay, then it's clear B, clear P1.0, then again call some delay, and while writing the delay routine, guys, make sure that yes, okay, let me write down this main. While writing the delay routine, guys, keep in mind delay routine should be written in this fashion. Delay, the register which you are using at the start, move R0 comma hash. It's a very simple technique. Most of you still don't know about this. Move R0 comma hash to 55, then move R1 comma hash 100. I have taken random values, but I can't go beyond 255. Can anybody tell me the specific reason why I can't go beyond the 255 through this registers? I can't go beyond 255. I'm expecting your answer in the chat section. Why I can't go beyond 255? Anybody? Yes, yes, correct, Ramiz. Yes, 2 raised to 8. Every register is an 8-bit register, and we can have 2 raised to 8 combination. That means Gauri is asking, she is having one doubt. Yes, Gauri, please go ahead with your doubt. At max 256. Nowadays, can assembly language used in industry? Yes, they do, Gauri. Because wherever the code density matters, means on-chip memory is very less. If you look at 8051, we do have only 256 bits of memory, 256 bytes of memory. So this is a very less memory, and wherever there is a very less amount of memory, at that place assembly language is used, because assembly language is lengthier, but it saves very, very efficient in terms of memory saving. So that's why assembly languages are preferred in even industry as well today. Yeah, so let's start with the code. Where did I kept the code? Okay, so this was the code. Move R1 comma hash 100. Then while writing a delay routine, I told you that what sequence you have to follow. The register which you have written here, the same register you have to decrement, guys. And how to decrement that? See, DJNZ R1 comma, R1 comma, and keep in mind you have to the jump of that register should be in front of the same register with the same label here. Same label, don't forget to take down the same label. Okay, done with this. So we are done with this register and its decrementing operation. Now it's turn for R0 register. So same instruction I'm going to use. Okay, I'm just a bit lazy about programming, so I just copied the code. Sorry for that. DJNZ R0, and now here, but keep in mind label should be different. So here I would like to use here one label, and this DJNZ R0, now this here one label should not be written here, but it is expected to be written here. So here is written like this. So if it is making not any sense, then I would like to write back, and here I would like to write back again, and here back one, and same label. So guys, did you understand the how to write down delay routine? And after the delay routine, make sure that you are returning from that delay routine. So RET instruction must be used, RET, and after RET end instruction, this will end your enter code. So SJMP main ORG00H, it signifies me, ORG stands for originate, from where we have to start writing the code, and it is done through the 00H. So that means from the 00H programming location. Then we do have, I have explained the theoretical part of this code. Now I don't think there is an issue regarding understanding the code now. So I would like to copy this Control or Control C. So guys, MID 51 software you have to install. I would like to share the link as well. And I will also share the text document through via mail. Even at the start, I have also shared. Guys, see, I do have, okay, I have already saved this. Okay, so let me save this. So this is the link which I'm going to share you for downloading the MID software. You can easily download that from the Google Chrome or from any of the search engine. Okay, so once you are done with this, then what I have to do, I have copied the code. Now I would like to open my application MID 51. So I would like to go with opening the MID 51. Then just go into the file, click on new. Guys, don't worry, you can repeat this session because I'm going to provide the recording of this session. So we are done with the typing the code. I can't zoom in this screen. I have tried a lot of times, but I can't. Make sure that you have to save this file with save as. Go into the file menu, save as, and make sure that you have made an appropriate folder. So right now under documents, see here, this PC under documents, or I would like to make it onto the desktop. Onto the desktop, I would like to make down one folder. Here my folder name is suppose 8051LED. Always make sure that you have made a proper folder so that all the necessary files will be saved here. And here I would like to write led.asm. So that .asm will be your extension to the file. And here by default it's showing all MCS51 known files. So just click on save. You can see the change in the color. I think there should be some error. Let's see what are those errors. Okay, so once we are done with the saving the file, then go into the build and go on to the build and only click on build. So it's showing no errors. Okay, it's pretty good that it's having no error. But guys, if there is no error, then keep in mind that if there is no error, then it will show the hex file has been generated. So we have saved the file with LED name, led.asm. You can see at the top led.asm name, and the file has been now saved with led.hex file has been generated. And now we are expecting this file to get dumped or burned into your microcontroller. So guys, have you understood this procedure, MID51? Or you can check, see here, onto the desktop I do have 8051_LED folder. Under that I have made led.asm file. So I would like to close this, or I would minimize this. Let's check. Yes, I do have that folder with me. On that folder, yes, led.hex file. This is .hex file is the machine level file, machine code file that we want to execute. Okay, so guys, let me know it's completely visible. Guys, did you understand this procedure? It is the syntax that all code should be written in blocks. No, it's a low level assembly language. Yash is asking, sir, what is ORG00H for? Yash, whenever we have to write down the code, that code should always start from the initial memory location. ORG stands for originate. So you should start writing the code into the memory from 00H location. Obviously we do have every single bit is important for us. And Kunal, no, I have written the code into the capital. You can write down it into the small words as well, not capital words. Okay, small capital, everything is allowed. But keep in mind when you are using where I have written the code, yeah, when you are writing about the labels, keep in mind guys, if you are written about labels, this labels, see here Kunal, back one and this back one, it should be written as it is. Means here you are, if you are writing in small letters and here you are writing in capital letters, it's not allowed. Label should be same, main. So where it is jumping, so it is jumping onto the main label. Okay, like this. So they should have the common tags or the common format. Yes, we are done with this. Now we have to go into the Protease 8. We are done with our file now. So we have to go into the Protease 8 Professional, which is already installed in my laptop. In order to download called protease. Those who don't have the protease with them, for them, guys, I'm going to share the this file, microcontrollers text file. Here you will find out the protease professional with crack. You can download this onto the above link. Okay, you will have the Google Drive link as well. So it's up to you how to download, because sitting over here, I can't help you in downloading the software. I can tell you how to use the software. Okay. Or simple, I have to take the access of your laptop through AnyDesk or TeamViewer software, and then I can help you in downloading the software. But best way, you can simply download that from this link, and I would like to share that with the help of mail. So done with this. Now I'm opening the protease. So you have to go into the protease professional, then go into the file menu, go into the new project. Once we are done with the new project, so it will ask you to give some name to your project. Always make sure that your file will with have .pdsprj extension. So here I would like to write down, suppose LED and today's date I would like to write, suppose this is 30. So 30. And it is now present under which folder. So you have to just browse this. Guys, I would like to have the same folder on desktop. 8051 LED was the name of my software, folder. And here I would like to make one new folder. And in this new folder, I would like to write protease. Okay. Protease_LED. So I would like to store our file into this. So this is selected folder. So yes, this folder has been selected. Make sure that always make a new folder. Click on next. Then do not create any schematic. Do not create a PCB layout. Then no firmware project. Finish. Then click on finish. So done. After that, you have to go into the IC schematic capture. And here you have to go into the components mode. So only here, from here you can take down the components mode, then go into the P. So P stands for peripheral. Here I would like to search for ATmega 8089C51RD2. So this is 8051 based microcontroller. You will find out RD2. So here, see, 8051 microcontroller. So I'm going to select this microcontroller. Just select this and click on OK. So once it is done, now you have selected. You will find out the list over here. Just select this with left one click and just drag and place it onto the schematic. So like this. You can zoom in the screen with the help of this. And in order to properly reposition this, you can simply select this green rectangle, and you can position this in this fashion, and just after dragging left it. Now you have to go with the LED. So again, go into the P and just click on LED. I would like to take down the simple animated LED so that it will be properly visible. So click on LED. Okay, let's go with the blue LED or green LED. I would like to take green. And yes, it is selected. Just place it over here. We have to use P1.0 now. Okay, so I will place it over here. So I have placed it over here with the help of left click. Then in order to take down a ground, you have to go into the terminals mode, component mode. So this is sub-circuit terminals mode. So here, click on terminals mode, go into the ground, and then click over here. So done with this. Now in order to have a wire connection, just make sure that bring the cursor onto the one end of LED, then just simply once left click, and then keep the left click mouse in that same position and just keep on dragging like this. Okay, once it is made with connection, just one left click and left again. start from the other end of LED and then towards the ground and then one left click just. So we are done with the interfacing diagram. Guys, this is the actual simulation, software based simulation. So not need of any VCC or crystal oscillator connection which we have seen earlier. Are you getting, guys? Okay, so no need of connection of this crystal oscillator. Can you see XT1, XTL2? Here we have to connect the crystal oscillator and there is one connection for the VCC as well. So no need to connect this. So now we have to run the program into this microcontroller. So what I need to do, just double click once, double left click. Then here it is asking us the program file path. So program file path, go into the folder, Protis_LED. No, this wasn't our folder. Our folder was 8051LED and in that we had LED.hex file. So just select that file, click on open and click on OK. So we are done with this and just after that click on run. So this is the play pause button, you can say. Just click on run. So can you see the LED flashing, guys? Green LED is flashing. If it's not that much visible, then I can zoom in the screen as well. Can you see the LED flashing? Can you see the LED flashing, guys? Yeah? Okay, fine. Great to have you all, guys. Okay, so you can simply pause the connection, guys. See, here through this I can pause this connection. So pause this connection with the help of this and then followed by stop the simulation. So you can simply stop the simulation. Guys, keep in mind, can we have some changes in the code? Can we have two or more LEDs? Reena, shall we have new interfacing diagram? Okay. So let's go with the new interfacing diagram. So let me take you through the LED program again. The same LED program. Okay. So same LED program, guys. Suppose one more LED I am going to interface, and that LED, suppose we will write its name is suppose set B P1.1. Okay, and the same here also I would like to clear P1.1. So what will happen here, that I am setting two LEDs, I am turning on two LEDs and then I am turning off two LEDs at a time. Same code I am using, but just control all, control C. Where I have to go, I have to go into the MID 51. Onto the same code I would like to override this, guys. Onto the same code. See, I am just copy pasting the code and then click on save. So what will happen? Whatever procedure which we have done already, I'm not going to repeat this procedure. So I've just copied, overwritten that code, new code, and just click on build. Don't forget to build. No errors. Its hex file has been generated. Now the same hex file I have to burn into the Protis 8. So in the icon you can see Protis 8 is already present here, but I have to interface one more LED now. Correct? So one more LED, then I have to go into the again components mode here onto the Protis 8. Then I have to go for the one more LED. So LED already having, but I would like to take down a different LED. This is red LED. I would like to take down the different LED. So LED, I would like to take down blue LED, suppose. Blue. So I would like to track down the blue LED and it should be interfaced to the P1.1. So just bring it here, then go into the terminals mode, ground, then click on this, then just drag here. So we do have two LEDs, one is connected to P1.0, other one is connected to P1.1. So both LEDs will be turned on simultaneously and both will be turned off simultaneously. This is our code, but we have to burn the code here. Make sure that, guys, keep in mind that before burning the code into the controller, you should stop the execution. Your execution should or must be stopped before burning the code into the controller. So just double click once. Here it will ask you for the program file, same path. Previous file has been now overwritten with help of new code. Okay, and then just click on start. Guys, can you see both LEDs now are blinking, green as well as blue LED? Let me know in the chat section.